The Peugeot has had brilliant starts all weekend, but this is the most crucial one of all. The revs are up. Here we go. Semi-final time. Hansen with a great start, Markland 2. Hansen moves across, going to try and put Scheider out wide. No contact so far. Nitic manages to get past. Doran's gone backwards. Nitic around the outside, going to get P3. Oh, massive! Over the curb. Tyre is off. Nitic launched over the curb, landed on the roof of Anton Markland, and has damaged the roof and taken the rear wing off the car. Kevin Hansen leads. Where is that car parked? It's parked round the outside of turn one, so I think this race will continue. Smoke from the back of Scheider's car as well, so maybe damage to the bodywork.
We were super worried about those orange curbs all weekend, and it just goes to show why, you know, those first couple of tussles in the corner, just you get caught up in it, and got massive, you can see massive damage on the back of Markland's car.
I mean, Nitic's car was on top of the car, but there we go, this is the way it is. So Markland's gone Joker 1, there's no rear wing on that car as well, and bear in mind, obviously, that with the high-speed stuff here, that's going to affect the handling for him. Timo Scheider in P2, Liam Thoren is in P3, Kevin Hansen out front, you can see Scheider. Scheider's been moving this car around quite a lot all weekend.
Yeah, there's been a lot of movement on the car, smoke pouring off the back, maybe some
It's the bodywork, so you can see the bodywork is underneath. Nitic is out, that's a great shame. He's only going to do a few events this year from the sound of things, so he'd be really disappointed about that. Right, let's take a look back then at the start from semi-final number one. Dan Rook, have a little pick over this for us.
So yeah, Kevin had a fantastic start and got away cleanly. In the background, you can see Rain is trying to make the most of his grip position and try to go around the outside, and just got out of luck, and there was no room for him to go, and he collected that orange curb there.
See, he actually had contact, didn't he, with the rear right of Markland. You can see this, wow, look at the sparks and the wheel there, damaged as well. But the curb has fully launched him there, unfortunately. Well, look, yeah, that's the way it goes. Markland moving across, where's he supposed to go? He can't. Basically, don't think you can lay the blame at either driver there. Dan, you drive enough. What's the score here?
No, I mean, 3-1 just doesn't go, is it? Because they were all just trying to fight for a line, and I'm sure Markland wasn't quite aware of how close he was to the inside, and it happens. I think that's just classed as a racing incident.